After almost 6 months of political wrangling, Iraq finally has a new government. On Thursday, former intelligence chief Mustafa al-Kadhimi, the third person to be nominated for prime minister this year, secured parliament's seal of approval. 15 ministers from his 22-member cabinet were also passed.
We are going through a critical phase in our history. Iraq is facing so many challenges in our security, economy, healthcare, and even socially, but it is not bigger than our determination to stand up to these challenges.
To earn the vote of confidence, Kadhimi had to appease major political parties by letting them pick ministers in his cabinet, an informal yet deeply entrenched power-sharing system known as apportionment.
He had 10% of freedom to choose his cabinet, and 90% were determined by the parties and blocs.
Names of ministers were swapped until right before the vote, amid last-minute backroom negotiations. Some parties which didn't secure ministries, including Nouri al-Maliki's State of Law Alliance and Ayad al-Alawi's National Coalition, boycotted the vote.
This is a strange approach, and it's a dangerous precedent in the Iraqi political scene. The candidates of his cabinet, that's 12 ministers, were presented to the Shia parties, and they gave their point of view, but it was not shared with the rest of the political parties. It's as if the Shia powers are the guardians of the political process.
Kadhimi replaced Adel Abdel Mahdi, who resigned in November amid widespread anti-government demonstrations. Protesters had demanded an overhaul of the political system that would allow them to elect the head of state directly and do away with the apportionment system, seen as a conduit for corruption and political patronage. But the protests have largely died down over the past months, and with them, the pressure for systemic change. The few demonstrators who remain in Tahrir Square rejected Kadhimi.
Any government that is formed inside parliament without the opinions of protesters will be rejected. Let them instead bring those to account who are killing, kidnapping, and arresting us on a daily basis.
Kadhimi comes to power as Iraq faces an unprecedented fiscal crisis, a resurgence of ISIL, the coronavirus pandemic, and US-Iran tensions on its soil. Kadhimi has put forth an ambitious government program, but it remains to be seen whether he'll have the power to execute it. The government formation process has shown that he remains beholden to the same political powers that Iraqis blame for the current crisis. To many, his appointment signals the preservation of the status quo rather than the first step on the road towards change that they have demanded. Simona Foltin, Al Jazeera, Baghdad.